Hello and welcome to Fluent Solutions. In today's video, we want to look at continuous functions. Okay, continuous functions. And when we say a function is continuous, then we want to look at continuity at a point, right, and continuity within an interval. So if this function f of x is continuous at x naught, then means we want to look at three conditions that must be satisfied. So f of x is continuous at x naught. If it is continuous at x naught, then we want to look at three conditions. Conditions that this must actually satisfy. So theoretically, we're saying that the first one should be that x naught. So first one, x naught should be in the or must be. Okay. Must be in the domain of f of x. So if this function is continuous at x naught, then this x naught must be found in the domain of f of x. So then let's look at I, that's the second condition. So I, we're saying that the limit of f of s as s approaches s naught, it must exist. So the limit must exist. Right. Then the next one or the last one is to say that the limit of f of s as s approaches s naught should be equal to the function value at s naught. So theoretically, this is what we want to talk about. But geometrically, we want to represent this line. Right. And the Cartesian plane, for instance, we are looking at something like this. So let's take this function to be f of x. So these are x and our y. So what we want to do is to say that, okay, so let's have certain value we want to call s naught. So we have the origin, and this one here has its corresponding y value here. So its corresponding y value is say f. Now realize that when we find the limits of this function, so the limits of f of s as s gets closer to s naught. When we move from the left side to the right side, then we realize that all that will be getting towards f. So as we move to x from the right, we are moving and the function value or what we are getting closer to is towards f. And to the left we are getting towards f. So you see that this is equal towards f. So it means that at this point, when we substitute this into the function, it means that we're having a point here whose coordinates we write as s naught and what l, for instance here, x naught and what l. But this l here will be written as f of x naught. Okay, so that we say that f at s naught is also equal to f. So the golden condition has been satisfied, which is that the limit of f of s as s approaches s naught equals f, and the limit of and f of s naught is also equal to l. So the function is continuous at this point. There is no break here. But analytically, so we are doing introductory analysis, so we want to analyze. Then if the function is continuous at s naught, then analytically we want to say that the limit of f of s as s approaches x naught is equal to this. So we could have stopped here, but see, this has an equivalent statement, which is that given any epsilon, given epsilon positive, any epsilon positive, there exists delta, which is a function of epsilon And it is greater than, you don't have enough space. Nice jump. So given epsilon positive, there exists delta, which is a function of epsilon, and is greater than zero. So such that x minus x naught less than delta implies that the absolute root of f of x minus f of x naught is going to be less than epsilon. So that means that the function is actually continuous at the point x naught. So that is the analysis as far as this is concerned. Now we also look at continuity within an interval. So let's look at continuity in an interval. So if a function f of x is continuous on an interval, then we see that it is uniformly continuous. So uniform continuity. Or we say that it is uniformly continuous. That means there is an interval. So at every point we need an interval, the function is continuous. So we say that it is uniformly continuous. But how do we see this? Okay, so if we have this function f of s and it is continuous on an interval I, right, it is continuous on an interval I, then what it means in analysis is that given any epsilon greater than zero, alright, so there exists, we're going to say that there exists delta, which is a function of epsilon, and it's greater than zero, and such that for all x1, x2, that means we are taking x1, x2, which are all in the interval. If this function is continuous on this interval, it means given this epsilon positive, there is delta, which is a function of epsilon greater than zero, such that for all x1, x2, which are in this interval, then we want to say that the absolute of f of x1 minus f of x2, right, is going to be less than epsilon whenever we realize that x1 minus x2, the absolute of this one, is less than delta. So this is how we define uniform continuity, or when a function is continuous on an interval, then this is what is it about. Now actually in calculation or solving of problems, it's difficult for us to use this particular definition. So we have a simple remark that we always rely on. That remark is that, so you want to look at this remark. The remark is that we can use the approach for continuity at a point. Okay, so where we are going to say that if it is continuous at a point, then these conditions exist. Alright. We realize that in this particular proof, there will be the need for us to select a delta. In delta. So when the selection of delta is such that it doesn't depend on x naught, doesn't depend on that particular point, then it means that it is continuous in the interval. Then we say that okay, the function is uniformly continuous. Right. So the point I'm trying to make is that even though this is the definition for uniform continuity, when we are to prove that a function is uniformly continuous, it is better that we use continuity at a point, so that when using this and we reach the point that we need to select delta, and we have chosen delta such that it is not depending on x naught, then we say that the function is uniformly continuous. The inverse is correct. When we select delta and it depends on x naught, then it means the function is continuous at that point, but not uniformly continuous on the interval I. Alright, so we'll stop here. We'll meet in the next video where we look at an example concerning how to prove that a particular function is continuous or uniformly continuous. I hope you download that language. Thank you very much.